Welcome to The Journey. Today we're going to talk about measuring customer satisfaction as a service-based business. So there's one concrete way to know, are you doing a good job? Are your customers satisfied? And it's not necessarily tied to revenue or sales, but it's actually looking into satisfaction. Are my customers indifferent or dissatisfied with the work that I'm providing?
Yeah, getting that clear feedback from your customers allows you to figure out where you're exceeding, meeting, or falling short of expectations.
So why is measuring customer satisfaction so important? Well, feedback's gonna let you know how you're doing, because you might think, oh, I'm providing top-notch service, but the feedback is actually gonna let you measure that more accurately.
Yeah, it helps you figure out where to put your energy and effort. So if you improve something, but that doesn't matter to your customers, then that's a waste of time. So you might as well figure out where you can actually improve.
Plus, feedback can help you improve your process, not just about how you're doing or your products and services are, but also that working relationship that you have.
Yeah, it's not all about that product, it's more about that full customer experience.
Yes.
So even if you have the best product out there, if that experience or that process is terrible, then it's gonna fall flat.
So feedback helps you identify needs and areas of potential offerings that you could improve upon and keep that conversation going, that dialogue. Don't just assume everything's working perfectly fine.
Yeah, just because something worked 5 years ago doesn't mean that it's still gonna work now. And of course, happy customers lead to happy referrals. And those long-term customers, that's really important for making sure that your business is sustainable. So they're gonna bring their family, their friends, help spread the word, and then your business is gonna benefit from that.
So here's some tips to know to help you measure customer satisfaction. First off, know your goals, right? Before you ask for feedback, you wanna have your goals in place so then you can, once you get that feedback, you can then get a strategy in place that makes sense for that finish line that you're trying to reach.
Then decide how you wanna measure that customer satisfaction. There are a ton of different rating systems that you can use to really figure out and get the best, most informational feedback.
Yeah, like a customer satisfaction score. I had this happen recently. I had just gone to the doctor. I recently moved, so I got a new doctor in the area. And it was as I was leaving, they said on a scale of 1 to 10, you know, how was your visit? I also tried, I tried acupuncture recently. That was pretty cool. They did the same thing, the customer satisfaction score. From 1 to 10, how satisfied were you with us putting needles in your body and relieving the pain?
Or you can measure with a net promoter score. So this is how likely someone is to actually refer them to like a family or a friend. So Emma, how likely are you to recommend your acupuncturist to me?
Well, funny you mentioned that. I would recommend him. But funny thing is that's how I was introduced to this acupuncturist. A friend referred me. So yeah, check it out if you have any pain. And there's also a customer effort score. So I like this one because it asks the customer, hey, you went through this process. How difficult was it? Was it really difficult? Really easy? Just difficult? Just easy? Or neither?
So once you figure that out, you wanna ask follow-up questions, but keep it simple. You don't wanna get crazy and ask people to take a 10-page survey where they don't have time for it. So keep it simple here, but make sure that you're digging a little deeper. So if they're not satisfied, you know, what would you recommend to help us improve?
Yeah, that's a good point. So if in the event I go to the acupuncturist and they ask, hey, you know, how was it? And I notice after a few visits, actually, you know, I'm not really that satisfied. I'm not noticing a change in the pain in my shoulder. Well, they shouldn't just stare at me blankly, right? Be like, okay, you know, how could we change this up? Maybe have you tried going to our chiropractor here or the massage therapist at our business? Dig deeper into that. Also ask about maybe some activities I've been doing in the meantime that could contribute to more pain. And that's good for the acupuncturist to know. So dig a little deeper, but keep it simple.
Another thing to keep in mind is regularly ask your customers for feedback. Don't just ask it once and then never ask again. Make it part of your process and make it really easy for them to be able to give you feedback.
Yeah, I do this often even with my own team at GoDaddy, checking in on who I manage. I don't just ask once a year. A lot happens in a year. So to give feedback of how my process is going and the goals we're trying to achieve, how's that working for you? What could I do better as a manager? It's good to just check in. I recommend the same thing at your business.
However, measuring customer satisfaction doesn't always have to happen through these like planned out tactics.
Totally. One thing that I always recommend, tap into your social listening. when you're already out there, hopefully, on sites like Facebook, Yelp, Google, and I'm going to share some examples on the screen, but when someone writes you a review, this is unsolicited feedback from your customers. It's very authentic. So I encourage you to not only pay attention to the reviews you're receiving, especially on the main, most popular platforms, Yelp and Google, but then go and respond to that. Another way to tap into social listening, pay attention to when you're mentioned on Facebook, or someone retweets you on Twitter, or talks about you on Instagram. Every time you're mentioned, what is that customer saying? Again, unsolicited feedback, super helpful for your business to acknowledge, digest, and respond.
Lastly, don't forget to track your customer satisfaction data over time. You can get those numbers, but it's not gonna mean anything if you can't implement it. So look at that data over time. How has it grown? You know, in what areas did it fluctuate?
Yeah, and start early if you can, definitely. So you start collecting, set that trend in the beginning so you have the insights on what's working and what's not. Data is super powerful. All right, that's a wrap. You just learned how to measure customer satisfaction for a service-based business. Be sure to like this video and comment below, how likely are you to recommend the journey to a friend?
Oh, very likely. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring that bell so that you're the first to know whenever we upload more new videos. This is The Journey. Thanks for watching.